For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Report 5 from your Sample Files folder. Next, make sure that you're in Page Layout View. You'll remember that you use the three icons at the bottom right of the screen to change views. This is Normal View, and this is Page Layout View. In the previous lesson, you applied an Auto Header and an Auto Footer. Auto Headers and Footers provide a quick and convenient method when your needs are simple. Custom headers allow you to combine your own text with report fields, such as page numbers. You're also able to add text to three different sections in the header and footer area: the left section, the center section, and the right section. I'm now going to click in the center section of the header area. And notice that the text has changed to page, space, ampersand, and then the word page in square brackets. The ampersand is called an escape character. It tells Excel that whatever text follows is a field rather than literal text. The field ampersand and then page in square brackets tells Excel to insert the current page number. I'm now going to change the center part of the page header area to simple text, the Gourmet Food Company. And in the left-hand part of the header area, I want to insert the date and time. Now, there's no auto header for date and time. In this case, you'll have to create your own custom header field. So I'll type the text printed on, followed by a colon and followed by a space. And then in the Header and Footer Tools Design ribbon, notice there's a large number of header and footer elements, and one of them is the current date. So I'll click Current Date, and you can see that the escape character, ampersand, followed by the word date in square brackets, has been inserted for me. Now I'll press the space key on the keyboard and type the word at, followed by a colon and a space. And I'm going to now insert a time element. That's Header and Footer Tools Design, and in the Header and Footer Elements section, the current time. This should now add today's date and the current time to the left-hand part of the page header section. I'll now click into the body of the worksheet, and you can see it's done just that. Now, on your machine, you may not see the date and time presented exactly as it is here. And that's because the way in which dates and times are presented depends upon your computer's locale, something that's set in the Windows settings. Because this machine has a USA locale, I'm seeing the date in the format month, day, year. So this date means the 20th of June 2014, and I'm seeing the time in the format 4:56 p.m. But you'll see the date and time in a format that's appropriate to your own locale. Now I'm going to put the page number in the right-hand part of the page header, so I'll click in the right-hand part of the page header. From the last lesson, you probably remember that there is an auto header for the page number, but you can't use it. Auto headers may only be used in the center section of the header, not the right section, so you'll have to make your own using the header and footer elements, just as you did for the date and time. So I'll type the word page, then a colon, and then a space. Don't worry that you can't see the space. When you add the field, the space will be there. And now I need to insert a page element. That's Header and Footer Tools Design on the ribbon, and in the Header and Footer Elements group, page number. And you can see that, once again, Excel has inserted an escape character followed by a field enclosed in brackets. And the field this time is called page. And when I click into the body of the worksheet, you can see that the page number is being returned by the page field. Now I'm going to make the text in the header and footer area look a little more attractive. I'll click in the left-hand part of the page header and then click the Home tab on the ribbon. Then in the Font group, I'll click the Font drop-down. From Session 4, you'll remember that it's best practice to always use theme fonts. There are two theme fonts, Calibri Light for headings and Calibri for body text. So the logical choice here is Calibri Light. So I'll change the font to Calibri Light. I'll now reduce the font size by 1 point by clicking the Font Size drop-down and selecting 10 points. And I think I'll make this bold-faced by clicking the Bold button. Now I'll change the colour of the text by clicking the Font Colour drop-down, and in the same way that it's best practice to always use theme fonts, you'll also remember from Session 4 that it's best practice to use theme colours. So I'm going to choose from the theme colours at the top of this dialogue and not the standard colours or the More Colours option. And the colour I'll choose is this one, the blue-grey text 2 theme colour. So I'll click, and I'm now happy with the formatting of the left-hand side of the header. I think I'll do exactly the same thing now to the right-hand part of the header. So I'll click in the right-hand side of the header area. I'll set the font to Calibri Light, the font size to 10 points. I'll boldface, and I'll choose the same font colour. Now I'll do something a little more special with the main heading in the centre section of the page header. I'll click in the centre section of the page header, and I'll take the font size right up to 28 points. Once again, I'll select the header theme font of Calibri Light. And I'll choose the same colour as last time too, the theme colour, blue-grey, text 2. And when I click back onto the body of the worksheet, you can see that the header now looks quite attractive. But sometimes you'll need a page header that requires more sophisticated formatting than Excel is capable of. The solution in this case is to create the header as a graphic using a program such as Adobe Photoshop. When the graphic has been prepared, you need to click in the header area and then Header and Footer Tools Design, and in the Header and Footer Elements, the Picture element. You're then able to insert the graphic into the header. Before ending this lesson, I'd like to answer a very common question that I receive from students in my classroom courses, and that is, how do I insert an ampersand into the title? For example, your company name might be Marks and Spencer, but as you know, the ampersand is an escape character. So when you click away from the header area, the ampersand disappears. Well, the answer is to type two ampersands. When Excel sees two ampersands in a row, it knows that you really wanted to print one ampersand. And when I click into the workbook again, you can see that I have the header that I wanted. But I'll change that back now to the original header of the Gourmet Food Company. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Sales Report 6. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above, my Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 7-8, Add Custom Headers and Footers.